So we'll pick up the coalition melee phase of 1040 turn of Austerlitz. Means we've completed the fire and movement phases. We'll just kind of review where we stand with that. Telnitz is out of reach, so the Austrians are just going to snipe. The Russians have been able to move up some guns, but because all of Nostitz's cavalry is gone, they're in danger of being flanked, so they deployed in a strange position there. Just avoid getting ridden down. And we see Sokolnitz has had very little movement. The Russians are continuing to try to assault into the town. So they've moved up some guns, did some good damage there. Going to try to melee across the Goldbach there. We see melees against the skirmishers there, probably just push them out of the way. Going to try to hit those guns, get them out of the way. It's pretty effective in firefights on both sides. And then finally the pheasantry. Going to try to push across the wall and get at those skirmishers again. So we'll start here. On the right, we have one battalion. Five against four. We'll roll our pre-melee morale checks. Very high number, so the French pass. And this is not looking so good. They are 31, so they are going to disorder and get that guy out of there. So we're forced, because of our time constraints here, to mount assaults without good preparation. I'm just hoping for the best. And both sides of this assault on the 1st of the 18th have failed. The Russians were trying their best to get at them, and both attempts failed. Not surprising. No preparation usually leads to poor outcomes, but again, it's the time. We don't have a choice there. Now we'll make this assault here on the guns. Even though he's got the 26 right in front of him, he wants those guns out of there. So he's going to four increments to one. And the guns roll very high, a 56, so they stand. And the Russians also stand. This is going to be a 5-1 assault. So we will roll. Got a very high number of 52, which is a rout, which we know destroys the guns. So those are the only guns of Legrand's division. So that hurts. We'll advance that battalion. So he gets out of the town, but he manages to open up that side of the position. Now here, we're going to have skirmishers do what they do and get out of the way. Well, I think I'll retreat here and then one more into the chateau. Since they were both assaulting the same hex, we'll have them advance into the hex. Thus they each have an increment loss. So they close with those skirmishers. Skirmishers got their good shots in. and then ran away. And the last will be here in the pheasantry. I think we'll do the same thing. We'll just retreat those skirmishers that overstack. Yields a morale check. And we fail the morale check. It's unfortunate. We can move those grenadiers. We'll move. Technically, that was a one shot. So they retreated before the other guys could assault. So those were our melees in the south. Making a little bit of progress, but frankly, not enough. Let's move ourselves to the center here. So we'll pick up the destruction of St Hilaire's division here. See, the second of the 36 right there is completely surrounded. Now, they might be a candidate for a melee, but why bother? They're completely surrounded. We can just keep sniping at them and destroy them in our own time, especially given that we have a whole line of infantry and some cavalry right in front of them. We'll just leave them where they are. That leads us to charge of the dragoons here. They are going to hit that disordered battalion, which is 6/7 of 17. Half of that. And the dragoons are a huge number. They are 56, which is doubled for charging in a straight line. It's a big number. We could potentially try to preserve readiness. Yeah, that's a good idea. We'll preserve readiness, which is another divided by 3, but that still maintains a 5-to-1 attack. So we roll the numbers. 24. Obviously, we were hoping for better than that. But that disorders battalion. 1, 2, 3 hexes. And an increment loss. And the dragoons advance. They are only tired. Since we preserve their readiness, we'll mark them so they can't recover. So, not terrible, but not great. Now if we move here, we can see Landron's right at flank here, pushing forward. We have a melee here against skirmishers. Have them run away, of course. Going to mark them since they moved more than half and advance that battalion. Again, we've got skirmishers all along the line here. Russian battalions looking to engage them, and we'll retreat yet another skirmisher battalion. And advance. Now this one is a little more interesting. If this battalion retreats, he opens up the flank of that French battalion. Normally I would think, I don't want to risk that battalion getting hit in the flank. He's already taken a severe beating by those Russian guns. He doesn't have any way to beat them. So getting hit and meleeed and retreated, it might be the lesser of two evils. Oh, there's a problem with that strategy. We have that covered by a zone of control. So those skirmishers are going to have to stay. They don't have any room to retreat because they're blocked by zones of control. So they are hit by 6 increments. They'll try to stand. See how many here they have. They will have 2 increments. And the grenadiers also pass, so we have a melee. So we have 2 6s of 16. And the grenadiers are 6/7. Of 19. Odds of 2.5 to 1, roll of 56. So the skirmishers disorder, retreat, retreat, retreat. And they will fall back. And they will advance here. So, first of the fourth is in bad shape. Guns, infantry all around them. Boy, this fourth corps fell apart. I blame the commander. We have a couple more. Basically, we have an entire regiment trying to run into a French battalion. It's going to be a little dicey, even though an entire regiment against a battalion might seem like a good deal. It's a large French battalion. We're going to give it a shot anyway. 6, 5, and 4. Against 7. It's too bad, but 2 of the Russian battalions stand. 1, unfortunately, did not pass his check and disordered. They stand, they go in. So we have 12 and 14, 26 against 7/8 of 22. Oh, that'll be a 1-to-1, right? Now, Vendôme is present. So, well, we don't need to see what he does because we rolled a 13. So that's an attacker disorder. which is not good. That's great for the French. Bad for the coalition. They wanted to take an advantage on this end and turn it into a breakout, and they failed. But maybe it was a dicey shot. So the last one we'll throw are some grenadiers here, trying to take out those guns. So there's one increment of gun, two increment of infantry. Each are passing, so this is going to be two-thirds of seven against one. So we roll a defender disorder on the guns, which is not enough. It's the only disorder in place. We do not destroy them. So that's a little disappointing. So our last assault is actually going to be these Cossacks against that routed battalion. Three-sevenths of 18. And we roll a disorder, which is good enough. We bust up some more infantry. And I guess we will move to the north. Now, Bagration has fallen apart in the north here, almost as catastrophically as Soult has fallen apart in the center. In an effort to restore a bit of the line on the road here, we have that Hussar regiment going against these Chasseurs. So we have 5/7 of 19. Fatigued. Tired, I guess I should say. And 46 on that big Hussar regiment. Wow. So we rolled boxcars. So, damn. That is Milhaud and 16th surrender. and these guys are now fatigued. That was by far the most successful attack. And it also brings an end to our melees for this turn.